everything that you need. I love you more. Every breath truly my BDB do. I will be strong, will be faithful, cause I'm counting on a new beginning. A reason for living, a deeper meaning.
Mom, Mom. Love you. Oh, you too, man.
Congrats. Thank you.
Number one friend. Oh, you good?
What are you doing?
That's okay. Love you.
Love you. Love you too, buddy.
Thank you. Love you too.
Love you.
Why are you wearing your hat? Love you.
Love you too, buddy.
I think you're just talking loud, Devin.
Hey, man. I love you, buddy.
Thanks, Rob.
Thank you.
Thanks for seeing me. Oh, she pukes.
Love you, buddy.
All rise, please.
A whole new world!
Everyone, I'd like to have you move in a little bit, get a little closer. I'm not mic'd.
Malfunction.
Okay.
Back up a little.
No,
no, nailed it.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would like to welcome everyone here today, and thank you for being here on one of the happiest days of our lives. And let's remember those who cannot be with us today. Keith and I are over the moon excited to have Nicco be part of our family, and are looking forward to sharing many more great memories with the DeMasca family. Thank you, Kim and Steve. You raised a wonderful, caring human. Maddie and Nicco, we love you so much. Keith, do you give our daughter's hand in marriage to Nicco?
Yes, we do.
You were nervous, huh, Nicco?
Oh, I had an option?
No.
Thank you, buddy. No,
thank you. Love you.
Now I go?
Yep. I don't know. Fuck off.
Hey, no, that. Okay.
Your dress is awesome.
You're talking to my son. That's great.
Oh, good.
I would like to start the ceremony with a poem Maddie wrote for Nicco last year.
Oh, my God.
It pretty much... She doesn't know that I was kind of snooping around and things and got a poem. It pretty much sums up their love for each other over the past 8 years and why we are here today. I've asked Kelsey to come up and read the poem. Kelts?
I wrote it?
I have no idea. I didn't write shit. Killing it, Deb.
Little fumble there. Okay.
Hey, guys.
What's up, Kelsey?
So my name's Kelsey. Anyone who doesn't know me, I'm Maddie's best friend.
Hi,
Kelsey. Hi. So Maddie and I have known each other since we were 8 years old. And I've had the distinct honor of basically vetting any crush that she's ever had since we were 11. And I can say with total confidence that I've never met anyone who I thought was worthy of spending their life with Maddie. This is so cheesy, but it's so true, until I met Nicco. So like Deb said, we snooped around a little bit and found this poem that you wrote to Nicco on your anniversary last year. Do you know it already?
I don't.
I actually wrote this.
There once was a tall guy who thought he was pretty fly when he asked a girl named Maddie to have dinner and eat some patties. They quickly fell in love and realized they would never get sick of. They thought life could never be more than, but then they adopted Coogan. Lived in 3 apartments before they said hell no rent, packed up and moved to Londonderry, where he asked her if she would marry. She said, no shit, in a lickety split. Her ring would make you throw a fit. Now they are 2 Huns who are more lucky than anyone to have found their lifelong reason to always be freaking cheesing. And I just want to say, I love you guys so, so much. Maddie has a bigger heart than anyone I've ever met, and you're beautiful inside and out. And Nicco, having gotten to know you for the last 7 years?
Thanks, dog.
You're literally her equal, and I didn't think that could ever happen. And I also want to say thank you guys for letting me sleep in your hotel room on the eve of your wedding after I got locked out of my hotel room.
I was so confused when I woke up.
I love you guys so much.
I was like, yes. I love you. Yeah.
I'm good.
Are you going to your vows first?
Nicco and Maddie, the most wonderful moment in life is when you meet that person who makes you feel complete. The person who makes the world a beautiful and magical place. The person who you share a bond with, the one that you cannot imagine spending another day of your life without. Nicco and Maddie, this is the kind of love you have for each other. To have found your lifelong reason to always be freaking cheesing.
Perfect.
Nicco and Maddie, to make your relationship work, take love and patience. Continue to date each other. Never be too old to hold hands and always say, I love you every day. At this point, Maddie and Nicco would like to share their wedding vows.
I have to go first. Good.
Oh my God, that's a lot.
It's only one page. Jade has big handwriting.
Okay.
Alright. I'm going to do my best to talk loud. We also had a microphone, but that didn't work out. But all good.
One job.
Use your teacher voice.
Leave your brother alone. I was going to say, that's your boy.
March 9th, 2015. I haven't told you that I started writing these letters yet. I think they'll be nice to look back on when we're old as shit. Sorry for swearing. With you having gray hair and thick glasses, and you've probably mastered all sorts of dance moves with your cane. You are absolute sunshine, Nicco, in every possible way. The night Hannah lit her hair on fire, I knew I wanted to be around you. On New Year's Eve, you made me promise that my midnight kiss would be Aggie. And being the person you are, you planned one hell of a first date at Dave & Buster's. A million things have happened since that day, and I am so thankful to have you in my life. Jason. 2,834 days later, you have proved to be the most wonderful, exciting, hilarious, and challenging experience of my life. So, let's do this thing. I promise to love and celebrate you as much as I do Coogan when she zoomies. I promise to eat all of your fries, even when I wasn't hungry. I promise to forgive you when you shrink my clothes, but I make no promise about forgetting. I promise to love the Patriots and the Celtics and whatever that Texas soccer team is called. I promise to always tell you when you're not leaving enough space for the car in front of us, and to always record you when you get pulled over. I promise to support your dreams, even when that dream is buying a sugar glider, starting an alpaca farm, or buying a hot air balloon. I promise to always tell you exactly how I feel at every single moment of every single day. I promise to honor your obsession with Disney and all things Mickey Mouse. I promise to love you even when you buy a massage chair for our one bedroom apartment.
Not a good investment.
Or when you surprise me with the occasional guinea pig or hamster. I promise to love you for the rest of our lives.
My turn. All right. Babe, I love you so much. If you had told me that the super cute girl from my second semester at Keene State in my Education 101 class was going to be my wife, I would have said, you're crazy. Honestly, I cannot thank you enough for putting up with my shit for the last 7, almost 8 years. You are the love of my life. You are my entire world, and I cannot thank you enough for being with me through everything we've gone through. I promise that I will always be your booger checker, your spider destroyer, your midnight snacker, and the love of your life. I can't wait for our next chapter. I can't wait to start a family with you, and I'm so excited to just do this thing. All right, I love you so much.
Booger checker.
You got a lot of booger. You're good.
We're going to do some I do's and then we're going to do things. Okay.
Nicco.
Yo, what's up?
Do you take Maddie to be your wife, to trust and respect, to laugh and cry with, loving faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face together, to give your hand, heart, and love from this day forward?
I do. Sorry.
Maddie, do you take Nicco to be your husband, to trust and respect, laugh and cry with, loving faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face together, to give him your hand, heart, and love from this day forward?
I do.
We're going to do the rings. Who's got the rings?
I have no idea.
Mikey?
You got the rings.
Gianni, can I have Coogan?
You want them right here?
I don't know. Do I?
You just take both of them.
This is mine?
Yeah, dude, that's yours.
Wait, so why do I have this?
I'm supposed to give them here. So you give that one to Maddie.
Yeah, that one.
Okay, don't do it.
Doesn't fit.
Sit. Good girl.
Yeah.
Good girl. Wait.
1 second.
I know, I see you.
Okay.
Hey.
It's okay. I don't care.
These rings represent the vows and promises you both have exchanged. They reflect the commitment to the words which inspire for all your hopes and dreams for the future. Nicco, place the ring on Maddie's finger and repeat after me. So listen up.
Does it do it now?
Yeah.
We didn't practice this part.
Push.
I give you this ring.
No, it does.
You say that.
I give you this ring.
To show you how much I love you.
To show you how much I love you.
This ring has no end.
This ring has no end.
Neither will my love for you.
Neither will my love for you.
I choose you, Maddie, to be my wife this day and every day.
I choose you, Maddie, to be my wife this day and every day.
Tom.
Thanks, that was hard.
Maddie, place the ring on Nico's finger and repeat after me.
A splinter.
He's a splinter.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
It's the wrong hand.
Oh, you gave me the wrong hand.
I know, I tested you.
Redo.
Oh, shit.
Lick it.
Get it wet, Nicco.
That's my boy.
Okay, redo. This one doesn't have a splinter.
Yeah.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
To show you how much I love you.
To show you how much I love you.
This ring has no end.
This ring has no end.
Neither will my love for you.
Neither will my love for you.
I choose you, Nicco, to be my husband this day and every day.
I choose you, Nicco, to be my husband this day and every day.
Nicco and Maddie, before I pronounce you husband and wife, I have one more thing I'd like you to do. This day is one that seems to fly by. It's filled with friends, family, and celebrations. Just take a look around. Take a look around and look at all the people who love you and are here for you today. So I want you to take a few moments and look into each other's eyes and think about that happiness you're feeling right now. Now I want you to think about your life together. Raising a family, thank God. Growing old together.
What?
Knowing that your visions of the future are not identical, but always complementary. John Lennon once said, a dream you dream alone is only a dream. A dream you dream together, that is reality. That new reality starts today. I know, get to the point right there.
Promise everyone 15 minutes.
Did you tell anyone?
Nicco and Maddie have declared before us today that you'll live together in marriage. You've made special promises to each other by joining hands and taking the vows by the authority vested in me as mom. No, in the state of Vermont. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Nicco, you may kiss your beautiful wife.
Go, come on. I don't know where we go now. Fucking get it.
Let's get it.
That's my time. Let's go. Yeah. Thanks, brother. Thank you. Didn't mean that I couldn't see shit. Oh, yeah, of course. Thank you. Do you want me to still have this or do you want it? Oh, you didn't give me this. Thank you for coming, man.
We did it.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah,
what's up,
brother?
I don't mind
the
bar to see if you guys are there.
Yeah.
Oh. It's okay. Oh, I told you it was going to be fun today.
Probably the wildest party goers going. Bring them on in. The party of the bride and groom. Let's go.
Thank you.
doing their first dance. Bridal party, gather around them. Gather around the bridal party.
Huh? You guys wanna see some shit?
Thank you. But we now have Maddie come on out and her dad.
Back down from a punch. Well, I take it square on the chin. Boy, tough little boys grow up to be dads. They turn into big babies again. Scared me to death when you took your first steps. Well, I'd fall every time you fell down. Your first day of school, I cried like a fool, and I followed your school bus to town. Well, I'm a grown man, as strong as I am. Well, sometimes it's hard to believe. How one little girl with little blonde curls can totally tear.
Thing that you could possibly imagine. In
BMW!
House. He has wrecked every car since he was 3 years old. Okay, and but aside from that, my wife's and our entire life, literally, well, is with those boys, those three boys that we could not ever have been proud of. I just gotta say one more thing, that Nicco has inherited every bad trait that I ever had. I'm sorry about that.
Do a karate kick. Do it.
And Maddie, Matt, where's Maddie?
Matt.
I swear to God, there is nobody in the entire universe that can handle Nicco other than Maddie Matt. I could go on for like about 3 months and I'm gonna stop right here.
thank you so much for being here. You're all so important in our lives, their lives, and let's just have a freaking great time. Yeah. That's on behalf of Keith and I.
What she said.
What she said, you know.
Enjoy your dinners, everybody.
Trends, Nicco was born just before Mikey and almost 8 years before me. To this day, Nicco has always reminded us that he is the oldest brother and that he's definitely the biggest brother. But I'm sure you guys can always see that part. Nicco has been an amazing role model. Watching Nico's actions as a little kid, I learned that it is better to ask someone to simply move a car rather than get in the driver's seat and let them play sports car and crash into it. I used to paddle with my older brothers a lot when I was younger, and because of that, I learned a very valuable lesson. Snitches most certainly do get stitches. Yeah. Apparently, when I was little, I used to wish that when I grow up, I wanted Mikey's good looks and Nico's athletic ability. Let's just say I'm very glad that wish didn't come true. All jokes aside, you will meet a more fun, caring and passionate person than Nicco. He is the first person that will change his day around in order to help someone. Nico's worked his ass off to get where he is today, and he has created a wonderful life for himself, Maddie, and the sweetest doggy ever, Coogan. Although I know he's 8 years younger, he doesn't treat me any differently. Nicco has always made sure to include me in any activities that him and his friends are up to. I'm beyond fortunate to not only have an amazing older brother that I truly look up to, but also have a best friend that has always looked after me and made sure I was okay. Maddie, you are one of the hardest working, most trustworthy, and loving individuals I've ever met. For those who don't know, I've been living with Nicco, Maddie, and Coogan since the end of April.
Rent-free!
Rent-free, baby! There is a day that goes by that Maddie is working around the house, even after a stressful day at school, whether it's building additions on their shed, doing yard work, or tutoring. Maddie, I don't know if you know this, but you're truly such an inspiration and role model for me. You are always there to listen to me when I have a bad day, and you are always offering me the best input and advice. I would say that now that you and Nicco are married, I have gained a sister, but you have been a sister way before today. I truly think you and Nicco are perfect together. You guys always have an amazing time and are always doing fun things. You guys are such an inspiration on what a beautiful relationship should be. I love you both so dearly, and I'm super excited to see the growth the two of you experience during these next chapters of your life. I would like to provide a toast to the guru! To the
considering he invited 3,000 people to his wedding, maybe some of you don't remember.
I'm Michael. Most of you who do know me refer me to as Nico's brother, the far better looking twin, which is kind of rude, but extremely accurate. I want to start off by thanking the parents of the bride, Keith and Debbie Giroux.
Yay!
Thank you, guys. This is a perfect night. I also want to thank the parents of the group.
Oh.
Steve and Kim. Kim or Kelly. For raising two incredible sons in Nico. Nico's obsession with me.
Yeah.
A guy couldn't get enough of me sharing a womb where he stole all my nutrients. Clearly you can tell, you know, he still does that. We shared a bedroom for what felt like forever. Even when we finally got our rooms, this Jimoke would come crawling down the hall to sleep in my bed, which was suboptimal because he wet the bed. Did you ever get that under control? But man, this guy knew how to push my buttons. He would drive me up a freaking wall. I swear to you. But you know when I react by dragging him headfirst down a flight of stairs, letting his face smack every other step.
I'm the bad guy.
And you know, seriously, I get so mad at him. My parents thought I had a brain tumor for a little bit, but it's actually a true story. So fast forward into early childhood, in high school, still can't get away from this dude. We were in every class together. Thanks, Mom. Finally got some space for him after 7 weeks of college, but then he sneaked his way to my graduation. For those who don't know the story, Nico actually wore an official Catholic gown, attended the graduation ceremony, and even walked up with a class and shook the dean's hand. Back to the story, though. Here we are, living in different states, and he manages to infiltrate my friend group, and even has one of them up here with him tonight. Shout out to Caleb Judas Bacon. Once I was no longer around to annoy, he changed his strategy to walk into my footsteps. I went on to be, as Nico likes to say, an assistant to the physician. But he went on to be an assistant to the grandmaster, so same thing. But finally, and most importantly, we both outkicked our coverage when it came to finding life. Shout out. It's crazy and Maddie. Next page. Unlike Nico, I love nothing more than to just roast all day up here. I have only great things to say about Maddie. Ever since I've known her, it was apparent that Maddie is an incredible person. She's funny, she's kind, she's patient, very patient, and incredibly thoughtful. I wasn't always living the lavish lifestyle that an assistant to the physician affords, but while in grad school, I frequently visit them in Boston, and she would always welcome me into their home. It's one thing to let your brother stay with you every other weekend for 2 years, but it's a whole different ballgame letting your boyfriend's family stay. Not only did Maddie open their doors to me on countless occasions, but made me feel like I was wanted and welcomed. She's now had Gianni living at her house for months with no end in sight. Sorry, Maddie. I can't say enough about her generosity and hospitality. It's time. And I think that's how these two attracted each other. Nico shares a lot of these qualities as well. During my frequent visits, Nico, knowing I was broke as a joke, never let me pay for anything, despite being their guest. He's also quick to forgive. He's the life of the party. He's annoyingly good at everything he does. And that to say, I'm so lucky to have him as a brother and fortunate to gain the sister I never had. I love you both so much. Cheers to these two.
different states here tonight, from Oregon, Texas, California, everywhere. We really appreciate each and every one of you coming here. It's August! They don't count. And we have a state senator here, we have Grandmaster. We want to seriously, from the bottom of our hearts, thank Sam and Terry, who hosted this entire party tonight. Let's give it up for Sam and Terry. We have Sam and Terry, we have our parents, our families, our friends, every one of you. We cannot thank you enough from the bottom of our hearts. You have anything to say?
Love you.
Yup. Now, there are some people that could not be here tonight, and one of them happened to send a video to, you know, just say hi and all that fun stuff. So we want to put that up right now.
Hey, Maddie and Nicco. Just wanted to take a moment and say congratulations. Hope you guys are having a great day. And in interest of full disclosure, this video was pre-recorded. So Nicco, if Maddie didn't show up today, I hate it for you, man. This is a little awkward. No, in all seriousness, I wish you guys all the best in health and prosperity. And from all of us here at Al Asad, Iraq,
so much for Maddie and Nicco. I'm the older sister of this stunning bride. I must admit that it came to a surprise when she asked me to be her maid of honor. I mean, she has so many great friends. Like, I don't even know this many people, honestly. It's absurd. I already know that Maddie is thinking, keep it short and untraditional. She doesn't like the limelight on her. Like, she doesn't like this whole traditional. But just for a second, I must get personal. Maddie, you've been my sister, adversary, confident, and everything in between. I don't need to get into detail on how we may have not seen eye to eye on everything growing up. Jane, are you my backup there? But even though we were at each other's throats, you always had my back when I would sneak out, throw parties, or try to convince that Camperman was real. Okay, everybody. Nicco, oh my God, the first time we met, or the first real time we spent time together, was at Disney, where you threw my leggings up on the ceiling fan and blamed it on Zach. I was so annoyed. And I'm still annoyed at you, Zach, okay? You bring this silly, neutral presence when you're around. Or even in a group text message as I'm cursing Zach out when you bring your popcorn beans.
Keep it going.
Thank you for being this positive, onesie-wearing goofball our family always needed. Lastly, what's a speech without a PowerPoint presentation, right? I mean, I've only had experience public speaking or with PowerPoint presentations at school. So I've drafted this PowerPoint presentation. Here it goes. Try to.
Oh, we need music.
Thank you.
running, I know, ya. Nothing shy, looking at the corner of your eyes. So I pick my heart up off the floor, move my feet closer to yours, catch my breath and I say, I'm the one you're looking for. So come on, come on, dance a little dance, take my hand, darling, take a chance. You be my queen, I'll be your king, show you everything that you've been missing, shorty. So come on, come on, dance a little dance, got me in a trance and just one glance. So don't wait no more, I'll be your more, I'm the one you're looking for, shorty. Girl, I see you over there hesitating, deliberating, you keep me waiting on a sign, looking at the corner of your eyes. So I pick my feet up off the floor, move my hips closer to yours, catch my breath and I say, I'm the one you're looking for. So come on, come on, dance a little dance, take my hand, darling, take a chance. You be my queen, I'll be your king, show you everything that you've been missing, shorty. So come on, come on, dance a little dance, got me in a trance and just one glance. So don't wait no more, I'll be your more, I'm the one you're looking for, shorty. I'll be the one you're looking for, shorty. So come on the dance floor and baby show me all your moves, all your grooves, shorty, I got something to prove to you. So come on, come on, take a little chance, got me in a trance and just one glance. So don't wait no more, I'll be your more, I'm the one you're looking for, shorty. So come on, come on, come on, come on, dance a little dance, dance a little dance. Come on, come on, come on, come on, dance a little dance. So come on, come on, dance a little dance, take my hand, darling, take a chance. You be my queen, I'll be your king.
It's a Nicco project.